Welcome once again. I welcome you all you my beloved lovely ones all over the world. I love you all so much. Okay, now I want to take you to the word of God. If a pastor have taken money from you through unjust means, if you have been a victim to all these fake pastors, all these demonic pastors, all these bloodsuckers that is out there destroying life, join me as I do this prayer. Let us go now into prayer and let this prayer be what you will. I want you to do it now. Do it, you know, every day, every time, and see what will happen to you. It's time for all these agents of darkness, all these agents of Satan, all these servants of Satan to go where they all belong. So I'm taking you now to the book of Psalm 140. This is the prayer for all the fake pastors. If you're a true child of God, join in this prayer. Say amen to that. Send it to as many people that they have destroyed their life, and let them join and do this prayer and see what will be happening to all these demonic men that call themselves pastors, bishop, prophet. It's time for you to be restored. Okay, let's go into the word of God. Psalm 140, prayer God gave to me for us to use to pray against them. This prayer is a prayer against all the fake pastors, fake bishop, fake occultic pastors that is there taking your life, sucking your life, taking your money, taking your joy, taking everything that belongs to you, and they promise you life, but they are killing you. Let's go now. Okay, let's go. All right, Psalm 140, I read, deliver us, all God's children all over the world. Deliver me, O Lord, from evil men. Preserve me from violent men who plan evil things in their heart. They continually gather together for war. They sharpen their tongues like a serpent. The poison of asp is under their lips. Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Deliver me from violent men who have purposed to make my steps stumble. The proud have hidden a snare for me and cords. They have spread a net by the wayside. They have set traps for me. I said to the Lord, you are my God. Hear the voice of my supplication, O Lord. O God, the Lord, the strength of my salvation. You have covered my head in the day of battle. Do not grant, O Lord, the desires of the wicked. Do not further his wicked scheme, lest they be exalted. As for the head of those who surround me, let the evil of their lips cover them. Let burning coals fall upon them. Let them be cast into the fire, into the pit, that they rise not up again. Let not a slanderer be established in the earth. Let evil haunt the violent man to overthrow him. I know that the Lord will maintain the cause of the afflicted, and justice for the poor. Surely the righteous shall give thanks to you. Surely the righteous shall give thanks to your name. The upright shall dwell in your presence. Now listen, I take you to verse 9. I'm reading Psalm 140. This is a prayer God gave to me for all the true children of God to use now to pray against the fake pastors that are seen as that is everywhere, all over the world, causing havoc. It's a prayer against them. A prayer that God gave to me that if we use this prayer, we will get all of them where they belong immediately. But I'm reading Psalm 140. But the place I want to decree something now is from verse 9. As for the head of those who surround us, let the evil of their lips cover them. Let that thing that they are written from their mouth to as many as they are, that poison that they are written from their mouth, that curses that are written from their mouth, as for the head of those who surround us, let the evil of their lips cover them right now in the name of Jesus. Let the evil of their lips cover them right now in the name of Jesus. In the north, in the east, in the west, in the south, let the evil of their lips cover them now in the name of Jesus. Let the evil of their lips cover them. Verse 10. Let burning coals fall upon them. I decree by the power and the authority in the name of Jesus. Let burning coals be heaped upon them. Let burning coals fall upon them, as many as they are. Let burning coals fall upon them now in the name of Jesus. Let burning coals fall upon all the fake pastors, fake bishops, fake apostles, fake prophets, fake teachers. Let burning coals, let burning coals fall upon them right now in the name of Jesus. Let them be cast into the fire, into deep pit, that they rise not up again. I decree by the power and the authority in the name of Jesus, let them be cast into the fire. Let them be cast into the fire. Fake pastors, fake churches, fake apostles, fake prophets. Let them be cast into the fire, into the pit, that they rise not up again. The pit that they dug for you, I command all of you to fall into it right now. By the power and authority in the name of Jesus, the name above every other name, at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, of those in heaven, of those on earth, of those under the earth, and that every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ in the Lord, to the glory of God, to the glory of God the Father. I decree, God, let them fall into the pit that they rise not up again. Let's continue. Let not a slanderer be established in the earth. Let evil haunt the violent man to battle him. Let them be soaked with evil. Every evil that they have released upon your life, let those evil go back to them now and soak them. Let not a slanderer be established. Those that are slandering our God, let not the slanderer be established in the earth. Let evil haunt the evil people. Let evil soak the evil people. Let evil soak them in the north, in the east, in the west, in the south. I command that evil that they send into your life, that they reason into your life, I command it to go back to them now by the power and the authority in the name of Jesus. I know that the Lord will maintain the cause of the afflicted. To as many, all of you out there that have been afflicted, let God maintain your cause now. I decree by the power and authority in the name of Jesus, let our God, the chief judge, now let the chief judge begin to set his own, all his children free. Oh, I know that the Lord will maintain the cause of the afflicted. Anywhere you are now, I say your father is the chief judge. The chief judge of the Supreme Court in heaven. He sits in heaven judging righteously. I decree the judgment of God through the word of God that you just hear in the book of Psalm 140 from verse 1 to end. Let it begin to manifest now in the life of this evil man and the evil woman that call themselves pastors. And let every good thing that belongs to you begin to come back to you. Begin to come back to you. I say, take your place. I say, be delivered. I say, be free. I say, be saved now. I say, be healed now. I say, be restored now by the power and authority in the name of Jesus. Let I give you praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for the power. Thank you for the souls that is hearing you now, that is being set free, that's been delivered, that's being healed, that your anointing and your power is touching. I give you praise. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you to millions of souls that you are delivering right now from the hand of this evil man and this evil woman. To be glory. I give you praise, Jesus. Thank you for doing it for all your children over the world. Thank you for setting us free from the hand of this evil and occult and demonic man that is there, piloting as angel of light, be their all angel of darkness. Thank you, because darkness has trapped them and soaked them now, and your light is shining now in the life of all your children all over the world. I give you praise, Jesus. You be glory forever and ever in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, if you love Jesus, spread this prayer. Let every child of God do this prayer. Send it and to as many can send it for them to use it to pray now. This is the end of the wicked, the end of evil in the world. God bless you real good.